Night, hello. Okay, wait a minute. You can hear my voice clearly, right?
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Ini 002.
And then let me.
Siti Mariam. Susanti.
Good night. Okay, let's start lesson. Do you have your module with you? Bukunya ada di dekat kalian kan? Hello. Do you have your book with you? Okay. Okay. Open page 80. Open your book, page 80 and 81. Already? Di situ kan ada bacaan. There is a text called the apple tree. Ada bacaan judulnya the apple tree. Ada yang mau baca? Gantian nanti. Ada yang mau baca angkat tangan. If you want to read it, please raise your hand. Okay, raise your hand. Okay. Santi. Mbak Santi. Okay, can you please read it now? I cannot hear your voice, sorry. Of the first paragraph first. The first paragraph. There was an old apple tree. There was an old apple tree with some sadness.
The only purpose served was to provide shelter for the sparrows.
Yes. Squirrels.
Squirrels in the neighborhood.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for your food.
Okay, thank you. Sekarang Mbak Amini. Okay. The second paragraph, please.
Hello. One day, farmer decided to cut the
Decided. Hello?
Hello?
One day, the farmer decided. Hello? Decided.
Hello?
Hello, hello? Can you hear me?
Hello?
Can you hear me? Hello? Jelas enggak?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Can you start reading?
One day, the farmer decided to cut... Jelas-jelas, Bu.
Jelas.
Hello?
Yeah, okay. Jelas kok. It's clear.
One day, the farmer decided to cut the tree down.
Down. Okay, and then?
What?
He wanted to get some
and a water right to ensure the wood supply from the tree. The wood was still strong, so taking a sharp axe in his hand. The farmer struck at off the tree.
Struck.
Hello?
Harus struck ya mbak ya, struck at the roots,
struck
at the roots. Terus yang tadi itu, he wanted to get some furniture made, and what better way to ensure, bukan ensure tapi ensure, the wood, ensure, the wood supply from the tree. Okay, thank you. Next, Mbak Ratmi. Good night. Okay, Mbak, the third paragraph, please.
Okay. Can you hear me, teacher?
Okay, the third paragraph, please.
Okay. At once, there was great commotion among the merry creatures had inhabited the tree.
Itu that
the grass for the sparrow and the
squirrels. The squirrels.
Squirrels came out of their dwelling place and
over
around the farmer. Please, sir.
They begged him. Hello? They begged. Hello, Ma. Are you still there?
Over.
Mm-hmm.
I repeat.
Okay. Paragraph selanjutnya.
Please, sir. They begged his strange life. Is it our only home?
They begged. Coba diulang. Hello, are you still here?
Paragraph.
No, the second one, please. The next one, please. Also,
the farmer only stuck harder at the root.
Mm-hmm.
We promised to sing to you in the afternoon when you fall away. It will lighten though. Entered the craters, but their cry were in vain.
In entreated.
The farmer continued his
task.
In entreated the crater. But their cries were in vain.
Mm-hmm.
Interest.
Creatures.
The farmer continued his talk with single
minded. Single minded.
He was in a hurry to finish off the chopping by afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
As he raises the axe one more time, sometime in the hollow of the tree caught his eyes a behalf.
Mm-hmm.
Upon looking closer, the farmer found that it was full of honey. Heavenly.
Okay, thank you. Next one.
Thank you.
Okay, Mbak, the next paragraph, please.
Ah.
suddenly
the farmer
realized
that tree was not
realized.
Suddenly the farmer
realized
tree was not realized that tree was not useless after all.
Useless.
The hollow was the ideal place for a
behave
to rest, and if her took away
if
the
he,
now the best world make more world certainly not abandon such unproductive residence. Hey, yo, up there, her anointed as the tree away the axe. I'm sparing the life of
this tree.
You can land in peace now. The sparrow, grasshopper, and squirrels with the dead sick of relic
was sigh.
Amazing that the farmer had found something of us.
Of use, so of use.
We'll try the tree after all. It was the only reason the tree was standing.
Okay, thank you. B. Wait a minute. Thank you. Ada kata-kata yang gak ngerti dari situ pasti banyak kayaknya. Agak susah. Oh my god. Hello. You still there? Okay. Wah, why suddenly like this?
Beehive.
Ada kata-kata yang nggak ngerti. Sorry tadi barusan error Google-nya, Google Chrome. Kata-kata yang nggak ngerti, coba my Google Chrome crashed. Google Chrome-nya nggak hang. Sambil cari kata-kata yang nggak ngerti. No music. Diperhatiin ini ya pronunciation-nya. X itu kapak. Sorry. The vocabulary that you don't understand. Kata-kata yang gak ngerti. Dengerin ya, apa biar tahu pelafalannya yang benar. There was an old apple tree in the farmer's garden. It was so old that it had stopped bearing fruit a long time ago. The only purpose it served was to provide shelter to the sparrows, grasshoppers, and squirrels in the neighborhood. One day, the farmer decided to cut the tree down. He felt it had become completely useless. Besides, he wanted to get some furniture made, and what better way to ensure the wood supply from the tree? The wood was still strong. So, taking a sharp axe in his hand, the farmer struck at the roots of the tree. Sorry. At once, there was a great commotion among the many creatures that inhabited the tree. The grasshoppers, the sparrows, and the squirrels came out of their dwelling places and hovered around the farmer. "Please, sir," they begged him, "spare this tree's life. It is our only home." But the farmer only struck harder at the roots. "We promised to sing you in the afternoons when you toil away. It wouldn't lighten your labor so," entreated the creatures. But their cries were in vain. the farmer continued his task with single-minded concentration. He was in a hurry to finish off the chopping by the afternoon. As he raised his axe one more time, something in the hollow of the tree caught his eye, a beehive. Upon looking closer, the farmer found that it was full of honey. Heavenly. Suddenly, the farmer realized that tree was not useless after all. Its hollow was the ideal place for a beehive to rest. And if he took away the honey now, the bees would make more. They would certainly not abandon such an attractive residence. Hello. Hey, you up there, he announced as he threw away the axe. I'm sparing the life of this tree. You can live in peace now. The sparrows, grasshoppers, and the squirrels breathed a deep sigh of relief. What a blessing that the farmer had found something of use to him, the tree. After all, it was the only reason the tree was standing. Okay. Wait a minute, Mbak Siti Aminah. Tadi pertanyaannya, okay, neighborhood. Tangga, neighborhood, neighbor, bacanya bukan make. Kemarin masih inget nggak hari Minggu kalau ada yang kayak gini yang g-nya nggak pernah dibaca. Neighborhood, dwelling. Dwelling itu bentuk dasarnya dwell. Artinya sama kayak live, sorry, live, tinggal. Jadi di situ dwelling places itu artinya tempat tinggal mereka. Eci, okay, breathe. Dari kata breathe artinya nafas. Yang lain ada nggak? Yang masih nggak ngerti? Sorry Mbak Risa, halaman 80. Page 80 and 81. Kata tempatnya yang mana itu? Yang mana kata tempat? Which one? Oh, bukan kata tempat, itu dwell itu kata kerja. Gak apa-apa, tanyain ke semuanya biar paham. Ada yang paling gak paham gak cerita ini soal apa sih sebenarnya? Walaupun nggak ngerti arti kata-katanya, ada yang ngerti nggak cerita ini sebenarnya ceritain soal apa? Oke, hageng lu. Tiba-tiba. Tentang pohon apel. Pohon apelnya kenapa? What's with the apple tree? An old apple tree. Terus pohon apelnya kenapa? What happened to the apple tree? The farmer want to cut it. Mau dipotong sama petani. Terus it already stopped bearing fruit. Itu kan di situ ada kata-kata ini ya, yang di kalimat pertama. It had. Itu artinya it had stopped bearing fruit. Artinya dia sudah tidak berbuah. Bearing fruit itu berbuah. Bukan disinggahi sebenarnya. Jadi kan di sini tadi bilangnya dwelling. Dwelling itu artinya tinggal. Jadi si sparrows, grasshopper sama squirrels ini semuanya tinggal di dalam pohon itu. Tidak tempat tinggal. Mbak Endang Rahayu, oke. Terus waktu petani yang mau potong, what do they do? Siput, nggak ada siput di sini. Squirrels tuh itu tupai atau bajing. Beehive, oke. Bacanya beehive. Alam, beehive itu artinya sarang lebah ya. Wiwi, nomor 3. Gagak itu apa bahasa Indonesia toh? Gagak is Indonesian. Burung gagak, sparrows. Oke, jadi ceritanya sebenarnya an old apple tree and the farmers want to cut it down. Seperti yang sudah kalian tahu, jadi pohonnya sudah tua, dikira nggak berguna, mau dipotong, tapi ternyata di situ ditemukan beehive, sarang lebah. Jadi petaninya nggak jadi nebang, soalnya akhirnya menemukan kegunaan pohon itu. Gitu. Ada lagi yang nggak ngerti artinya? Shelter. Ada yang tahu artinya? Jack Sparrow itu loh yang di film Pirates of the Caribbean. Sparrow artinya gagak. Sparrow-nya bukan berlindung sih. Itu kata kerjanya memang artinya berlindung, tapi kalau di sini squirrel itu tupai. Kalau shelter di sini artinya tempat berlindung. Bajing itu tupai. Terus decide. One day the farmer decided to cut the trees down. Decide. Memutuskan. Okay, good. Useless. Useless, tidak berguna. Okay, good. Announce, mengumumkan. Decide tadi memutuskan. And then ensure. Ensure. Di paragraf kedua, memastikan. Supply. Cadangan atau persediaan. X tadi sudah ya, kapak. Sharp, sharp stalk juga bisa. Sharp sharp. Tajam, oke. Root. Akar, oke, good. Commotion. Heavenly di situ artinya kayak surga gitu. Surga banget. Keributan. Tiba-tiba ada yang berisik gitu. Terus creatures. Creature. Bukan, itu create. Menciptakan itu create. Bukan creature. Makhluk hidup. Terus inhabit. Inhabit. Inhabit itu artinya menghuni, mendiami. Hover, mengelilingi, kayak merubung gitu loh. Hover. Jadi mereka ngerubungi si petani itu di sekitarnya. Back kemarin sudah ya, back mengerumuni. Back please sir, they backed him. Back mohon. Hollow itu, aduh, kata-kata bahasa Indonesia apa ya, pokoknya dia artinya bagian yang lebih rendah dibandingkan yang lain. I beg you itu artinya aku mohon. Aku mohon padamu, aku mohon. Toil away. In the fourth paragraph, yang di paragraf keempat. Toil away. Toil away, anyone knows? Bekerja keras. Sudah. Oke. Entreat. Entreat. Memohon juga ini. Membujuk gitu. In vain. Cik, Mbak diurutin dulu biar lebih gampang nyarinya. Apa nanti ya? Itu kan ada their cries were in vain. Itu artinya sia-sia. Chopping, chop chop. Memotong. Di situ artinya upon looking closer, setelah melihat lebih dekat gitu. Upon abandon. Abandon tuh bisa juga bilangnya mencampakkan gitu. Kurang lebih bahasa Indonesia. Yang mana yang upon? Oh, bukan. Which one? And then residence itu tempat tinggal ya. Throw away itu bentuk kedua, sorry. Sudah jelas sekarang? Membuang di sini. Sparing the, saya tadi Mbak Risa, sebentar. Dari mana Mbak? Belum selesai nulisnya. Which part you haven't finished writing? Yang mana yang belum selesai nulisnya? Which one? Sebentar, nanti aja nanti kalau gitu. You can live in peace. Realize. Itu ada yang sebagian tak masukin chat itu. Nanti diketinggalan nulisnya. Realize itu menyadari. Terus di sini deep sigh of relief itu kalau diartikan breathe deep sigh of relief. Halo. Semen itu artinya menghela nafas lega. Relief itu lega. Halo, Sutirahmawati, oke. Hard work itu juga kerja keras. Blessing. Berkat. Barokah. Page 80 and 81. Okay, it's okay. Tadi ya apa ya biar bisa jadi satu gitunya. Wait. Sorry, the connection was lost. Ini tadi. Bisa ya di itu ini. Sebagian sudah ada yang tak pindah di chat buat yang nggak kelihatan papannya. Certainly. Yang kalimat yang mana itu sebentar? Which paragraph? Certainly. Paragraf 5. Okay. Sebagian sudah ada yang dipindah di chat ya. Apa sih namanya itunya? Paragraf 5. Oh, pastinya. Certain. Certainnya tadinya pasti, yakin. Jadi di situ certainly, pastinya. Pastinya tidak akan meninggalkan tempat tinggal semenarik itu. Anything else? Ada yang lain atau masih sibuk mencatat? Anything else, or you still busy taking notes? Okay. Itu single minded itu jadi satu ya. Sebenarnya kalimatnya harusnya ada tanda hubungnya di tengah-tengah. Single minded artinya gimana ya? Fokus gitu loh. Jadi dia fokus di situ kan kalimatnya single minded concentration. Jadi dia benar-benar fokus untuk berkonsentrasi, dia benar-benar konsentrasi. Single minded dia enggak mikir yang lain-lain lagi. Gitu. Single minded. Are you still writing? Masih nulis kah? Yang sudah selesai nulis, coba dikerjakan activity 3 ya. If you have finished. Yang sudah selesai nulis, silakan kerjakan activity 3. Tadi mau nyoba gimana caranya bisa itu. Tadi sebagian yang sudah dipindah ke chat, jadi kalau mau scroll-scroll chatnya bisa juga. Atasnya, soalnya tadi bilang ada yang baru sampai tajam gitu. Segini, okay. Okay, now we are in page 18, Mbak Atun. Page 80, sorry. Page 80. If you have finished, please do SFD 3. Suara yang mana ya? The apple tree. Coba dikerjakan activity 3. Activity 3, page 81. Halaman 81. Come on. Ya, sudah selesai nulis, bisa dikerjakan activity 3 ya. If you have finished writing. Hollow tadi sudah itu. Di atas. Di papan tuh yang itu tuh. Sudah ada artinya di situ. Finish. Okay, you finish answering the question. Wait. Tunggu yang lain dulu ya, biar mereka selesai juga. I finish. I finished answering the questions ya, Mbak. Jadi kalau misalnya ada dua kata kerja dalam satu kalimat, geser kemana ini? Jadi nggak boleh finish answer gitu, nggak boleh. Entah itu finish to answer atau finish answering. Tapi dalam finish biasanya pasti answering belakangnya, pakai ing. Sudah cukup gesernya. Sudah selesai kah nulisnya? Kerjakan activity 3 ya. 3. Halaman sekarang halaman 80 sama 81, Mbak. 1881. To exercise, activity 3 on page 81. Finish. Have you finished? Activity 3. Halo, masih pada di sini kan? Are you still there? I think you'll fall asleep or going somewhere. Mungkin tidur atau... Okay, good. Yes. Lo ngemil gak apa-apa, pokoknya jangan tidur. Finish. Pas. Apa yang pas, Mbak? Okay, yang sudah selesai. Number one, what is the answer? Number one. Nyerah, emang sudah dicoba. Ok, Okay, the farmer, good. Number two, why did the farmer decide to cut the tree down? Number two, kenapa kok petaninya memutuskan untuk memotong si pohon, menebang? Because because he felt it had become completely useless. Okay, pakai bahasa Inggris ya mbak ya. Because the tree is old. Okay, he felt it had become completely useless. Number three, what's the device used to cut the tree? What's the device to use? Sharp axe. An axe ini juga sudah bisa. Axe. Number four, what did he find in the hollow of the tree? Dia nemukan apa? He found an axe. Full of honey, apanya? Yep, lebih tepatnya dia nemu sarang laba, beehive. Okay, good. Number five, did the farmer take away the honey? Apakah dia mengambil honey-nya? Yes, okay. How is the ending? Bagaimana ending cerita ini? How was the ending of the story? Ending ceritanya? What is the ending of the story? The ending. Akhir ceritanya, what is it? Pohonnya utuh tuh bahasa Inggrisnya apa, Mbak? Nomor dua tadi jawabannya, why did the farmer, okay, because he felt it had become completely useless. Nomor dua jawabannya itu. Gak usah di copy paste semua mbak ya jawabannya. In the end, the farmer didn't cut the old apple tree, gitu aja. Okay. Number two, because he felt it has become useless. Okay, itu ya jawabannya. And then the next one, open page 82. Please open page 82. Open page 82, activity 5. di situ kan ada paragraf yang masih nggak utuh kan, terus diurutin coba, masih nggak urut maksudku. Page 82, activity 5, rearrange the paragraph, ada kalimat-kalimat itu yang painting the wall, nomor 1 sampai 6 coba diurutin jadi paragraf yang benar. Please arrange it into a good paragraph. Coba sebutin nomornya aja nanti kalau sudah selesai. Number 5, activity 5, page 82. Page 82, activity 5. Please arrange the jumbled paragraph into a story. Kayaknya coba diituin dulu deh nomor yang mana yang duluan. Misalnya sampai ke 6-6-nya berurutan coba, jangan satu-satu. Diurutin dulu sampai selesai dari nomor 1 sampai 6. Suaranya nggak ada soalnya lagi nungguin anak-anak kerjain, Mbak. Number activity 5, page 82. Diurutin coba dari nomor 1 sampai nomor 6 urutannya yang benar seperti apa biar jadi paragraf yang bagus. Nomor satunya kok dua ya? Nomor satunya kok dua? Ayo, ulti lagi. Try again. Try again. Okay, 3, 4. Kurang sedikit lagi. Kurang dikit, Mbak, masih ada yang ketuker satu nomor. Dua nomor ketuker tempatnya. Still wrong. Masih salah, ada yang lain. Yang lain coba, mana jawabannya. Yang lain. Yang lainnya ketiduran ya ini. Okay, good. The answer is correct. 3, 1, 5, 4, 6, 2. Adek mau baca? Baca semuanya. Satu orang aja. Mbak tadi sudah, yang lain yang belum. yang belum sempat baca tadi. The other. Jawabannya 315462. Urutannya gitu. 315462. Ayo angkat tangan yang mau baca semuanya. Raise your hand. Ya, itu jawabannya, Mbak. Itu urutan yang benar buat activity 5. The answer for activity 5. Ayo yang mau jawab. Yang mau baca. Oke, Mbak Wawat ya. Nggak usah takut, nggak apa-apa kok. Tinggal 66-nya, Mbak. Jangan cuma satu. Oke, Mbak Wawat silakan. Nomor 3 dulu yang dibaca. Wait, still loading. Oke, Mbak, silakan nomor 3 dulu.
Cara bacanya gimana?
One morning. Dari nomor 3. Jadi nomor 3, 3, 1, 5, 4, 6, terus nomor 2. Nomor 3 dulu, Mbak.
Lima, empat, enam, dua. One morning, one of the rich friends came over to visit. When he looked around the room, he said, "Your house is empty. My house is more beautiful than yours." And the walls are
brighter. The walls are brighter ya, Mbak ya. Brighter. The witch was very angry when she heard. Ulang lagi, Mbak, dari the witch was very angry. Okay, nomor 1.
After her friend left,
the
witch looked around.
Faded, benar, faded. Repaint it. Bought a can of paint. Okay, sekarang nomor 5, Mbak, agak gak kedengaran suaranya lu. Number Okay, sekarang sudah okay. Nomor 5. Hello.
After lunch, after lunch,
The upper. couldn't reach it. And then number 6. Oh no, no, no. Sorry. Number 4.
She got
broom.
Broom.
And pain. Okay. And then. Paintbrush. Sorry, itu salah cerita. Started to paint the upper walls. Okay. And then. Was done. It worked very fast and the worked very very fast, and in 10 minutes all the jobs was done. Okay, and the last one, the witch was very happy. Okay, thank you very much. Kata-kata yang gak ngerti artinya. The words that you don't understand. Faded. Dari kata. Kata-kata yang gak ngerti coba. Dari nomor 1 dulu. Can di situ artinya sekaleng ya. Sudah oke kok Mbak tadi, sudah lumayan. Can di situ kaleng. Both a can of paint. Sekaleng cat. Broom itu sapu. Magic broom itu sapu ajaib. Witch di sini artinya penyihir. Oh, broom bulat. Sapu yang buat sapu-sapu biasa itu loh. Witch itu penyihir tapi perempuan. Itu brush. Kalau kuas itu. Tapi dia di sini ngecat pakai itu sapu, bukan tukang sapu. Nenek sihir kan bisa cerita-cerita kan punya sapu ajaib itu loh yang bisa buat terbang. Kayak di Harry Potter juga. Ada lagi yang gak ngerti artinya? Harry Potter mbak, bukan Harry Potter. Shout, itu teriak. Okay. Yang lain, reach, menggapai. Ada lagi. Sudah ya? Gak ada lagi. Walls itu tembok. Wall, tembok. Upper itu bagian atas. Lower itu bagian bawah. Dinding, walls, tembok, dinding. Anything else? Ada yang lain? Anything else? anything else? Gak ada ya, sudah ya. Are you still there? Malah perlu di absen lagi buat ngecek siapa yang masih ada di sini. Oke, ada yang masih nggak ngerti artinya di activity 5? Kalau sudah nggak ada, kalau sudah nggak ada itu ya, kita pindah ke pembahasan berikutnya. Terus buat narrative text secara keseluruhan, apa ada yang masih nggak ngerti? For narrative text, anything that you still don't understand? PR-nya dibahas, oh belum nanti. Belum sempat nilai. Harusnya memang pas TTM, tapi kemarin gak sempat. No time. Narrative text, anything else that you still don't understand? For narrative text. Setelah semua ya, nol mbak. Kapan-kapan. Narrative text, ada yang belum ngerti? Kalau nggak sempat bahas, nanti tak tulis jawabannya di apa sih, Facebook aja, di kertas sosial nanti. Kalau ada pertanyaan langsung tanyain di Facebook aja. Anything that you don't understand about narrative text? Kalau sudah ngerti buat apa narrative text segala macam, kita lanjut ke bahasan berikutnya. Kemarin nggak datang ya mbak? Yang kemarin TTM-nya nggak datang, nanti di upload kok, nanti di share kemarin slide yang dipakai. Narrative text intinya cerita aja, it's a story. Bacaan, cerita, dongeng, kayak gitu-gitu. Itu masuk ke narrative text. Okay, no questions. Any questions or not? Kalau nggak ada, kita langsung lanjut ke berikutnya. Okay, next. Nanti di share kok filenya, tenang aja. Ini kelihatan nggak gambarnya? Hari ini 120 menit, jadi sekitar sampai jam 11 mbak. Oke, sudah ya, kelihatan gambarnya ya. Next, gambar berikutnya. So long. Orang. pindah slide-nya lama sekali ya ini. One. Lihat aja gambarnya dulu, nanti pertanyaannya di terakhir. Wah, ini kok lama ya? Ya apa ini? Why so long? This one. Sudah kelihatan gambarnya? Karena hari ini pelajarannya bukan soal orang cakep, Mbak. Oh, solo yang kedua ini apaan? Ini yang gambar pertama ya. Ini gambar kedua. Sudah kelihatan kan, walaupun nggak jelas tulisannya nggak apa-apa. This is the second picture. This is the fourth picture. Sorry, connection lost. Oke, dari empat ini, itu kira-kira apa ya? Ini gambar apa aja ya? Yang pertama kan Halloween party. The first picture is about Halloween party. And then the third picture is about birthday party. And then the fourth picture is for marriage, for a wedding. Ini kira-kira tiga gambar ini soal apa ya? Bahasa Inggrisnya, the English please. English please. Undangan bahasa Inggrisnya. Celebrity. Invitation. Invitation. Jadi hari ini kita ngomongin topiknya soal invitation atau undangan. Undangan bisa macam-macam ya, bisa ngundang ke pesta pernikahan, ke pesta ulang tahun, apa pesta kelahiran anaknya. Oh, why so long? Okay, what is an invitation? Undangan itu apa sih? Ini definisinya sih. Permintaan tertulis atau secara verbal mengundang seseorang untuk datang ke suatu acara atau untuk melakukan sesuatu. Jadi for a movie itu juga bisa undangan. Wedding, Halloween party, terus habis itu pesta kelahiran anaknya atau ngajak ke movie atau cuma ngajak ke 7-Eleven. Apa cuma ngajak makan, apa ngajak kencan, itu semuanya undangan, invitation. Ada yang bisa kasih contoh undangan lain? Contoh invitation. Sunatan, okay. Yang lain. Undangan rapat juga bisa. Meeting. Pesta perceraian itu masa dirayakan ya? No. No for divorce party. Apa yang dirayain bebas gitu. Okay. So have you invited someone to your party? Pengajian juga bisa. Religious. Okay. Have you ever invited someone to your party? Pernah ngundang orang apa enggak? Undangan apapun, ke pesta atau ngajak kencan atau ngajak nonton atau ngajak ke 7-Eleven. Okay. Biasanya kalau ngomong ke mereka, what will you say to invite them? Apa yang akan kalian katakan buat mengundang mereka? Okay. what will you say to invite them usually? Okay, can you? Mbak pakai bahasa Inggris. In English, can you go with me tonight for a dinner? Okay, please come with me. Can you join me? Gak usah pakai with ya mbak ya, jadi langsung can you join me to watch a movie? Would you have a dinner with me? Bukan would you dinner with. With itu tulisannya with. With, would you have a dinner with me? Terus biasanya responnya mereka kayak gimana? How do they respond you? How did they respond you? Very happy. Pernah ditolak enggak? Have you ever been rejected? Pernah ditolak? No. Really? Kalau mereka nolak, mereka bilang apa? Selain no. No narcissist. Sorry, yang lain. Bisa saying you sorry. Busy, I'm busy. Okay. Okay. Jadi dalam bahasa Inggris ini ya caranya mengundang seseorang. Yang sebelah sini formal, yang sebelah sini informal. Thanks anyway, but I busy. I am. Okay. Di sini cara mengundangnya ya ada dua, formal and informal. There are two ways to invite someone. Ada dua cara. Yang pertama formal. Misalnya would you like to, enaknya apa ya lanjutannya? Would you like to, to apa ini enaknya? Would you like to have a date with me? Okay. Would you like to go to a movie with me? Kayak gitu. Iya, tapi kalau formal tuh biasanya agak-agak resmi. Would you like to attend the meeting? Would you like to attend a company's dinner? Kayak gitu. I'd like to ask you to. Kalau ini ya, I'd like, itu singkatan dari I would like. Itu artinya sama dengan I want. I'd like. Itu I would like bentuk panjangnya. Itu artinya sama dengan I want. Jadi I'd like to ask you to. Aku ingin memintamu untuk apa. Ask itu meminta. Di sini konteksnya artinya meminta. Bisa juga artinya bertanya sebenarnya. Tapi kalau buat mengundang biasanya meminta. Hah, bertanya juga bisa. Tapi di sini karena kamu mengundang seseorang, dia meminta, lebih ke meminta artinya. I'd like to ask you to, aku ingin mengundangmu, aku ingin memintamu untuk datang misalnya. To come to my wedding, to come to my party, kayak gitu. It will be my, yang ketiga, it will be my pleasure. It would be my pleasure if you would, kayak gitu. Pleasure, senang. Aku kan sangat gembira kalau kamu datang ke pernikahanku misalnya, kayak gitu. Atau ke pesta ulang tahunku. May I have the honor of your. Honor itu artinya kehormatan. Honor, hanya gak usah dibaca ya. Jadi misalnya tuh contohnya may I have the no curhat ya mbak di sini honor of your misalnya contohnya gitu may I have the honor of your presence in my party. Presence itu kehadiran, beda lagi mbak kalau honor yang itu. Ini nggak tahu ya di modul halaman berapa. Nanti aja aku juga lupa. Itu lagunya aku dari Serat Nasari lah mbak. okay. Ya, sekarang kalau ngomong ke teman, ini kan biasanya yang ditulis di formal ini kadang-kadang kalau undangannya formal atau biasanya nulis di kertas undangan apa di surat surat resmi dari kantor misalnya kayak gitu. Kalau informal ini biasanya antar teman. Pas kalian lagi ngomong sama teman, if you talk to your friend, if you want to invite your friend to do something, why don't we misalnya why don't we watch a movie? Kita gimana kalau kita pergi nonton? Why don't we eat somewhere? Kenapa gimana kalau kita makan di luar misalnya kayak gitu. I am buying my treat, it's on me. Itu semuanya artinya tak traktir. My treat, it's on me. Itu semua artinya aku yang traktir. Mbak fokusnya ke tulisannya ya, bukan gambarnya. Itu cuma intermezzo. Itu cuma hiasan. Okay. Atau bisa let's go to the beach, let's go to watch movie, let's go to a party, kayak gitu. Do you want to, itu juga, maukah kamu pergi ke movie atau pergi ke mana gitu kayak, atau pergi makan juga bisa. How do you fancy? Fancy. Itu kira-kira artinya kamu mau enggak? How do you fancy? Kira-kira artinya sih kamu mau enggak pergi kemana atau melakukan apa kayak gitu. Fancy. Ada yang bisa kasih contoh lain gimana cara mengundang orang? Let's, oh ya lupa. Let's itu singkatan dari let us sebenarnya. Ayo kayak gitu. Artinya let's go, ayo pergi. Let's watch movie, ayo nonton film bareng, kayak gitu. Let us, let's, berarti kamu ngajak orang lain untuk melakukan sesuatu bersamamu, bersama kalian. Ada yang bisa kasih contoh lain cara yang menginvite orang? Apa? Tanya apa ya, Mbak? Ya, kita juga boleh tanya dulu, are you busy? Kayak gitu. Basa-basi, hi, how are you today? Are you busy? Do you have anything to do? Misalnya kayak gitu. Kamu mau ngapain siang ini? Kamu ada acara apa enggak? Terus baru biasa. Kalau dia bilang enggak ada, oh let's go somewhere. Would you like to apa? Kayak gitu. Bisa basa-basi dulu. Udah paham? Ini ada pertanyaan lagi soal gimana cara menginvite? Any questions? Really? Next. Okay. Now we talk about how to accept. Gimana cara menerima ajakan itu? Kayak oh ya pada tidur, biarin Mbak. Nanti tak cari dari absen. Oke. Ini caranya accept ya. Cara menerima undangan. Sure. Okay. What time? Jam berapa? I'd love to. Thank you. Saat jam 11. I'd love to, thank you. That's very kind of you. Ada yang tahu artinya that's very kind of you? Artinya? Ada yang tahu? Kamu baik banget. That sounds lovely. Artinya? Very kind of you. That sounds lovely. Kedengarannya okay, kedengarannya menyenangkan, kedengarannya bagus. What a great idea. Artinya Wah, ide bagus. Oke, okay. Thank you, thanks itu sama aja. Tapi thanks tuh lebih ke kayak itu ya, informal ya. Gak boleh jawab pertanyaan yang, maksudnya undangan yang formal dengan bilang thanks gitu, gak boleh. Soalnya itu lebih ke informal, ngomong sama teman. Kalau sudah bilang thanks, gak usah pakai thanks, gak usah pakai you. Thanks, thanks aja. Thanks you, itu salah. Thank you, itu benar. Atau thanks aja. Oke, okay. Sekarang cara menolaknya. To refuse an invitation. I cannot. I have to do something else, misalnya. I have to go with my friends to another party, misalnya kayak gitu. Sorry, I have an appointment. Appointment artinya appointment, what does it mean? Appointment. What does it mean? Janji, sudah ada acara lain sudah dijanji. Oke. Okay. I'm busy, aku sibuk. Rain check itu apa ya? Mungkin. Rain check. Nggak pernah dengar artinya ya, sama kayak ngecek. Nanti tak cek dulu. Hey, can I check rain check? Adakah ada yang hujan cek? Ngecek dulu, bukan pengangkatan. Jadi I'm busy tomorrow, can I check rain check to that? Kalau misalnya dia bilang can I check rain check on that, itu berarti dia bilang aku ngecek jadwalku dulu ya, kalau aku bisa aku bilang oke, okay. Kalau enggak ya sudah. Jadi dia ngecek jadwalku dulu gitu. Bisa juga nolak pakai bilang oh that's very kind of you but kayak gitu. Kamu baik banget tapi kayak. Jadi dia mau nolak cuma dia bilang that's very kind of you dulu. Atau I'd love to but, itu berarti dia bakal nolak. Kalau sudah ada kata atau but, itu berarti dia nolak. I'm sorry, I don't think I can. I'm afraid I can. I cannot. Itu semua buat menolak. Ada yang bisa ngasih contoh lain buat nolak? What will you say to refuse an invitation? Can you give an example beside here? Selain yang ada di sini. Oh, oke. Okay. I've itu artinya I have. Biasanya dipakai buat perfect ya, perfect tense. Maaf saya bacain bahasa Inggrisnya, Mbak. Sama kayak I'd love to, I've got to, itu buat ngomongnya aja. I don't think I can. Okay. Bahasa Inggrisnya sorry, I have another thing to do. Kayak gitu. Maaf aku ada acara lain. Sorry, I have another thing to do. Aku mau ke acara lain, ada sesuatu yang lain. Atau another occasion. Okay. Now let's please listen to me. Jadi listening ya. Jadi nanti kalian cuma bilang aja si ini invitation-nya ditolak atau diterima gitu aja. Okay, I will read a dialogue. Aku bakal bacain suatu dialog. You have to answer whether the invitation is accepted or rejected. Jadi kalian tinggal menjawab apakah undangannya ini ditolak atau diterima. Okay? Okay, are you ready? Okay, enggak ada yang mau ditanyain dulu. Listening. Ready. Okay. Hi Hannah, how are you?
Hello Ricky, I'm very well, thanks. And you?
So am I, thanks. Anyway, are you free this evening?
I don't think so. What's up Ricky?
How about going to 21 movie to see a movie?
I think it's not a bad idea, but I have to accompany my young brother to study.
Okay, never mind. Maybe next time. See you. Rejected or accepted? Rejected or accepted? She want to accompany her brother, okay. The next one. Wait a minute. Rejected, accompany ya. Tadi ada kata-kata accompany. Itu artinya menemani. So the girl reject. Wait. The next one. A. What are you doing on Friday night? B. Nothing special. Why? A. Do you want to see a movie? B. Sure. What time? A. Can I pick you up around 7? B. Sounds good. Accepted or rejected? Kalimatnya yang menyatakan diterima yang mana ya? What are you doing on this Friday night? Nothing special. Why? Do you want to see a movie? Sure. What time? Can I pick you up around 7? Sounds good. Yang buat menyatakan diterimanya yang kalimat yang mana? Sure. Okay. Good. Next one. Between A and B again. Are you free next Saturday? I believe so. We were wondering if you'd like to go baseball game with us. We have an extra ticket. I would love to. Accepted or rejected? I'd love to. Okay. Itu ya kalimat penerimaannya. I would love to. Bukan I'll, tapi I'd. I'd love to. Accepted. I'd love to. Okay, good. Okay. Now, can you... Sorry. Open your book. Ah, itu tadi sudah di atas, Mbak. Tadi sudah dijelaskan. I would. singkatan dari I would. I'd love to. I would love to. Okay, can you open your book, page 72. Activity 4. Your book, page 72, activity 4. 72. Sudah? Sudah dibuka kah? Page 72, activity 4. Semuanya sudah dibuka kah? Yang lain? Udin itu siapa, Mbak ya? Okay. Jadi activity 4 itu kan di situ ada titik-titik kan? Nomor 1 apa, nomor 2 apa? Itu nanti jadi you listen to me. Jadi kalian dengarkan. Terus nanti titik-titik itu diisi berdasarkan yang didengar. Okay? Got it? Understand? Okay. Jadi nanti masing-masing kalimat aku baca 3 kali ya, biar benar-benar dengar. Agis misalnya nanti, "Hi Maria, long time, bla bla bla." Aku baca 3 kali. I will read it 3 times. Okay? For each sentence, I will read 3 times. Okay, first sentence from Agis. "Hi Maria, long time no see. How are you?" "Hi Maria, long time no see. How are you?" "Hi Maria, long time no see. How are you?" Nggak usah langsung dijawab di bukunya dulu aja. Nanti baru dibahas. Yang kalimat kedua, "Hello, Agis. Very well, thanks. And you?" "Hello, Agis. Very well, thanks. And you?" "Hello, Agis. Very well, thanks. And you?" Number 3 and 4. "Not bad, thank you." "Not bad, thank you." Number 3 and 4. "Not bad, thank you." And then, "What brings you here, Agis?" "I'm on my holiday. I'm visiting my grandmom." "How long are you staying here?" Number 5, now. "I'm not sure. Probably 3 days." Number 5. "I'm not sure. Probably 3 days." Number 5. "I'm not sure. Probably 3 days." "Maria, that's long enough. Anyway, are you free this evening?" Number 6. "I don't think so. We're celebrating my grandma's birthday." Number 6. "I don't think so. We're celebrating my grandma's birthday." Number 6. "I don't think so. We are celebrating my grandma's birthday. How about tomorrow? Are you doing anything tomorrow? Number 7. What time? Number 7. What time? Number 7. What time? At 3 p.m. I'm free at 3 p.m. What's up? Cinta is Love is on... What is that? On the cinema. Number 8. Why don't we see it? Cinta is Love on the cinema. Why don't we see it? Number 8. Cinta is Love is on the cinema. Why don't we see it? Alright, I come to see. Where are we meeting tomorrow? Number 9. In front of the movie theater. Number 9. In front of the movie theater. Number 9. In front of the movie theater. Okay, I'll be there on time. See you tomorrow, Maria. See you. See you. Number 10. See you. Okay, finish. Ada yang tadi enggak sempat nangkap? Number 8. Why don't we see it? Number 9. In front of the movie theater. Number 8. Why don't we see it? Number 9. In front of the movie theater. Jangan lihat kunci ya, percuma dong. Ini kan tujuannya buat listening. Kalau cuma buat lihat halaman belakang ya ngapain gitu loh. Namanya nggak latihan dong. Kalau lihat halaman belakang terus ya nggak usah latihan ya nggak akan pernah bisa. Ya, saya sih nggak pernah pakai yang ada di sini, yang ada di buku biar nggak bisa lihat jawabannya. Oke, exercise yang di papan ya sekarang. Let's do another exercise yang ada di halaman belakang. Yang nomor 1 ada yang bisa jawab yang biru itu. Yang biru. Yang biru. Yang lain dijawab dulu. Okay, good. Yes atau sure? Atau sure atau bisa juga okay. I'd love to. Yang hijau, the green one. The green one. Yang hijau. Drop by itu artinya mampir. Drop by. Jawabannya, the answer. Because I have to work. Ada yang lain? Ow. I can't because I'm working, okay. No, I can't because I'm working juga bisa. Yang lain. I'm really sorry, I can't because I'm working. Okay, juga. The other. I'm sorry, I can't. Pakai T ya. I can't. Because I'm busy, okay. Ada yang lain? Okay, gak ada yang lain ya sudah ya. Next, I'm so sorry because I'm working. Okay. Yang ini yang atas, berikutnya. The next one. Next one yang atas. No, bukan itu. Soalnya kan yang pertanyaan yang kalimat atasnya kan you can bring your husband to our party too. Kamu juga bisa bawa suamimu ke pesta kita. Berarti yang harusnya nggak tertarik siapa? It, it kan bukan buat manusia. Interest itu tuh tertarik. Tertarik. Bukan Mbak Risa yang nggak bakal tertarik itu bukan aku, tapi husbandnya. Oke, okay, I don't think nggak usah pakai so. Oke, okay. Langsung aja I don't think he would be interested. Atau I think he wouldn't be interested. He. Ini I'm not sure. I'm not sure. Pakai titik Mbak biar kepisah gitu loh kalimatnya. Biar jelas maksudnya apa. He wouldn't be interested. I'd like to, but I think he, jangan lupa he-nya, he wouldn't be interested. Yang ini enggak bisa. Jangan lupa titiknya, sorry, he wouldn't be interested. Iya, I'm not sure gak bisa, harus I am not sure. Itu kan sudah ditulis I'm not sure, pembetulannya. Thanks anyway, but he wouldn't. Okay. He wouldn't be interested. He wouldn't be interested. Okay, the next one. Would you like to? Yang bawahnya. The next number. Of course, that sounds lovely. Okay, benar. Yang lain. I'd like to, that sounds lovely, juga benar. Sure, that sounds lovely, benar. Sure, It sounds. Bukan, it sounds. Tapi, it sounds lovely. That sounds lovely, okay. Sure, sounds lovely. Yang lain, the other answer, sure that sounds, sure titiknya ya Mbak ya, that sounds lovely. P Anything else? No? Okay. Next. This one. Bikin bikin undangan, terserah apa aja. Jawabannya sure, we would like to come. Make the invitation. Acaranya jangan lupa disebutin, Mbak. Join itu nggak pakai with ya. Jadi langsung, will you join me to watch cinema? Join with itu nggak ada bahasa Inggris. Langsung join me. Would you like to come with me? Would you like to come with me to watch movie? Terus, would you want to come to my birthday party? Okay. You want to come? Okay. Ini, do you want to come to my party? Would you come to my birthday party? Okay. Jangan langsung you want to come to my party. Kayak gimana gitu. Agak kurang sopan kalau invite. Kecuali ya memang sama teman sih. Tapi lebih bagus pakai do you want to come to my party? Ada yang lain? Would you like to come to my sister's birthday party? I'd like to invite you to come to wedding party-nya siapa, Mbak? Jadi harus disebutkan juga my wedding party atau my sisters atau my siapa. Oke, tinggal 19 detik ya. Oke, see you tomorrow. Kita lanjut besok aja. Would you come? Itu kan menandakan milik kalau ada S-nya, sisters. Jadi buat tahu itu pestanya siapa. Menandakan milik, sisters party harus ada gitunya. Okay, see you tomorrow.